guys, this is Abhishek from GadgetJuice.com and today we are going to do the benchmark and gaming review for the Xiaomi eLife E6. This is the latest flagship phone from Xiaomi here in India and it has been launched for a price of around 23,000 Indian rupees, which is quite high for a phone of this hardware configuration which we have seen, but it will come down as far as the price is concerned very soon. Right now it is already available for a price of around 20 to 21,000 Indian rupees and it will come down further as well. For us, the best price for this device would be around 18 to 17,000 Indian rupees, which is pretty good for the kind of display which you get. You get a full high definition display on this device and the processor configuration is MediaTek 6589 turbo chipset which we have on this device. That means you have a quad core A7 architecture based processor on this device which is clocked at 1.5 GHz. When it comes to the GPU as well, the GPU is enhanced in terms of the frequency at which it operates. So it is running on the higher frequency as compared to the MediaTek 6589 normal chipset because this is the turbo chipset which we have on this device. So in terms of the graphic performance as well, this device is little bit better as compared to the MediaTek 6589 because this is the turbo version. So let's start the benchmarking first of all and we will start up with Antutu. So when it comes to Antutu, this device has scored a score of 15377, which is fairly a good score for a device like this. On Ninamark, this device has scored a score of 34.5 FPS or 34.2 FPS basically. So this is how the score look like, and when it comes to the score, this score is actually less than the score which we have got for Ninamark on Xiaomi eLife E5. Maybe the display could be a problem, but the score on this device is lesser. But in terms of the overall gaming performance, this device is capable of playing all the games which Xiaomi eLife E5 can play. Can also play some high graphic intensive games as well. We have got a score of 3797 and we have got a better score previously, and this is how the detailed score looked like for the CPU, memory, input output operation and 3D. Now starting with the gaming review, we would like to play the most casual game which is kind of common these days, the Temple Run OZ, and this game will give you an idea how the Subway Surfer or Temple Run 2 will run on this device as far as graphics and touchscreen is concerned. So here we have the game running and the graphics are loading fine. I do not see any issue. The touchscreen is also pretty responsive while playing this game. There is no problem. And the gravity sensor is also working well. Overall gaming performance of this specific game is pretty good. There is no problem. Sensors are also working pretty well. The second game which we are going to play is called Frontline Commando D-Day. The touchscreen is pretty responsive while playing this game, there is no issue. And graphics are also pretty okay. Not the smoothest which we have seen, but pretty fine. At least you can play this game on this device. One thing which I noticed while playing this game is that the response from the touchscreen is good, but it is not very stable. So it is very shaky kind of a response which I'm getting from the touchscreen while playing this game. Apart from that, graphics are loading okay. They are not the smoothest, but you can play this game on this device. So the third game which we are going to play on this device is called Real Racing. And let's see how does this device perform when it comes to playing this game. So as far as graphics are concerned, I do not notice any problem on this device while playing this game, and the sensors on the device are also working well, as you can see. I can see the reflection on the road, the sunlight effects as well on this device while playing this game. So the rendering of the graphics is smooth. As you can see the reflection on the car as well for the sunlight. And the sensors are also working pretty well without any issues. Overall, I do not see any problem with the draw distance as well. So this game is running fine on this device, as you can see. Now we are playing this game called Dead Trigger, and this is a kind of a graphic intensive game which we are playing on this device, and we are again going to play this game in the high graphic mode. So let's see how this device performs when it comes to playing this game. So as you can see some amount of graphic detailing when we are playing this game on this device. Touchscreen is responsive. Graphics are also pretty good while playing this game. However, the touchscreen is not very smooth in terms of the overall response which we are getting, but it is pretty okay to play this game. There is a slight lag in the touchscreen response which we can notice, but the overall game playback is not affected with that. And as you can see, the graphics are also pretty good because we are playing this game in the high graphic mode, so you can see some effects on the screen as well if you can notice them. The overall gaming experience is pretty good, I would say. There is no issue. Now we are playing this game called Riptide. And as you can see, the device is performing pretty good while playing this game. I do not notice any kind of graphic lag till now. And the sensors on the device are also working well, as you can see. Graphic wise, I do not see any issue as well while playing this game, as you can see. And the effects which I can see on the screen are also looking good. I can see good amount of details on the screen as well. So this game is running pretty well, both in terms of the graphics as well as in terms of the response on the device. So now we are playing Asphalt 7 on this device, as you can see. And in terms of the overall graphic performance, this game is running fine on this device. Although it is not the very smooth graphic performance which we have seen for this game on some other devices, but again, it is better. If you run this game for the first time, you will notice slight lag in the UI. But with multiple runs, it will become smoother in terms of the overall playback experience, as you can see. Still, you can play this game on this device without much issue, as you can see. But the graphics won't be very smooth when you play this game, that is something which we can tell you. But the overall gaming performance is pretty good. Watch your back, buddy. So you can play this game on this device, but you will notice some graphic lag. The overall gaming experience won't be that smooth, but you can play this game on this device. So the last game which we are going to play on this device is Modern Combat 4, and this is one of the most graphic intensive game which we are going to run on this device, and let's see how does the device respond when it comes to playing this game. So as far as graphics are concerned, I can play this game and the graphics are kind of okay, and they're almost smooth till this level. However, the touchscreen response is not very great. The touchscreen response is not very good, but the graphics are pretty okay till now. I can access all the touchscreen controls on the screen without any issues, but the overall gaming experience is not very smooth, I would say. But you can play this game on this device, that is more important. So the only problem is the touchscreen response, and apart from that, the game is running fine on this device. It's not much of an issue, as you can see. So this game runs fine on this device as far as graphics are concerned. The touchscreen response is not very good. That's all from us as far as the overall gaming performance and the benchmark review of the Jioni eLife E6 is concerned. Again, this device is pretty okay in terms of the gaming front. You can play almost all the graphic intensive games on this device. There will be a slight lag in some of the games which you will be able to notice, and the touchscreen response will not be good in all the games. When it comes to the graphic intensive games like Mortal Kombat 4 and Asphalt 7, you will notice a slight lag in the graphic while playing this game, but still you can play these games, that is more important.